Good afternoon, everyone. Let us now go for the next point in our topic, that is Hamilton's principle. Okay. Can anyone tell me what we have seen in the last lecture?
Derivation of Lagrange's equation of motion.
Derivation of Lagrange's equation of motion, that already we have seen in the first chapter, but in the last lecture we have seen this with the help of a Hamilton's principle. Can anyone explain me what is a Hamilton's principle? What is Hamilton's principle? A system of n particle or dynamical system of n particle, if it wants to move from position say P to Q within the time interval say T naught to T1, then it will choose a path such that the line integral of Lagrangian is extremum. What do you mean by line integral of a Lagrangian is extremum? It means that the delta variation in the value of integration I is equals to zero. Okay. The next derivation that we have seen is the new L dash, which is nothing but L plus d by dt of f of q j and t. Right. So this new L dash should also satisfy the Lagrange's equation of a motion. Okay. So these things we have to we have already studied. Now what is the next part? We have to show that the new L dash also satisfy the Hamilton's principle. Okay, in the last lecture we have to prove the two things. First we have proved the L dash satisfy Lagrange's equation of a motion. Next we have to show that the new Lagrangian L dash, whatever we have this one, the new Lagrangian L dash must satisfy Hamilton's principle. The new Lagrangian L dash must satisfy Hamilton's principle. Okay, what do you mean by it satisfy Hamilton's principle? That is to prove that delta variation in the value of integral I should be equal to zero. That is equals to delta variation in the value of integration L dash dt should be exactly equal to zero. Okay. Now let us go for the variation. What is our aim to prove? Delta variation in the value of integration I L dash dt equal to zero. Instead of having L, we have to prove the same result for L dash. Any doubt up to this?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so let us consider integration P naught to T1 L dash dt, that is we have to take the delta variation in that, right? Now what is L dash? We have to write down the value of L dash here. L dash is nothing but L plus d by dt of f of qj and t dt. Okay. Now let us prove the result, delta variation. Okay, let me write down the integration first. What is the integration? Within the limit T naught to T1, delta variation in L plus, you have to find out delta d by dt of f of qj and t. Now, no doubt this delta L, that means value of this term is zero, correct? Integration T naught to T1, delta L dt is 0. Why this is 0? Because of our Hamilton's principle. Na? What is Hamilton's principle? Delta variation in the value of integration. Which means that delta variation in the value of integration t naught to t1 L dt is equal to 0. This is Hamilton's principle. But the same result we have to prove for the L dash. So this term no doubt equal to 0. Now we have to prove the same thing for the second term. Okay. Now here you can see the integration and derivative are both with respect to t, right? And we have seen the result in the last lecture that delta d by dt is exactly equal to d by dt of a delta. So this delta, if I take inside, so what will be the reason? No doubt the first term is 0. So I can write directly the second term as integration t naught to t1 d by dt delta f of qj and t dt. Integration is with respect to t, derivative is also with respect to t. So what will be the resultant? It will be nothing but delta f qj t. Right? Now how to find out delta variation in f? This will be nothing but summation over j dou f by dou qj into delta qj. Plus, what is the next term? Dou f by dou t into delta t, right? This we have to write down within the limit, say t naught to t1, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Again, what is the conclusion here? In delta variation, we have to find out delta t. Now, as I told you in the last lecture, there is no variation in the time. That means the time is fixed out. That is, suppose it is 15 minutes. MSc first year students are allowed to move from point P to Q within 15 minutes. So the time is fixed out. So hence we can say there is no variation in time. So this delta T is zero. So resultant we get it as this term is zero. Also we know that there is no variation in the path, that is qj, that qj alpha of t is nothing but collection of all the path that starts from p and ends to q. And this alpha, for different values of alpha, we get a different curve, okay? So for different values of alpha, if we're getting different curve and points p and q are also fixed out. So what will be delta variation in qj? That is also zero, since there is no variation in the end point. So this term is also zero, this is also zero. So resultant we get it as a zero. That is nothing but integration t naught to t1 delta variation in the value of integration L dash is equals to zero, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so in this way we have proved the result that we have started in the last lecture, okay? Now let us now find out what is Hamilton's formulation, because actually we know L is nothing but L of qj, qj dot and t, right? This we know, but now we have to find out what is h. That means h is a function of some variable. We have to find out what are those variables, okay? Now the quantity, actually this was defined by Hamilton, hence it is called a Hamiltonian formulation. So hence it is called a Hamiltonian formulation. So actually how the Hamiltonian or Hamilton has defined this is nothing but the quantity summation over j pj qj dot minus l can be expressed in terms of q1 q2 up to so on qn p1 p2 up to so on pn and a time t is called a Hamiltonian formulation. Is called Hamiltonian formulation. Okay, so H is nothing but summation over J Pj Qj dot minus L, and it can be expressed in terms of Q1, Q2, Q3 up to Qn means what? Qj. P1, P2, P3 up to Pn means what? It is nothing but Pj, which is nothing but your P. How we have defined P? P is a momentum, which is nothing but mass into velocity, and time T. So how H is defined? H is in terms of Qj, Pj and T. Correct? So this is what a Hamilton's formulation, and we can write Hamilton's formulation as H of Pj Qj T is nothing but summation over J Pj Qj dot minus L. What is L? L is a function of Qj Qj dot and T. Okay, so H, the formulation of H is nothing but summation over J Pj Qj dot minus L. Okay, up to now we were having L is a function of Qj, Qj dot and T. But in this case, Hamiltonian H is a function of Pj, Qj and T. Okay? Have you understood the definition of Hamiltonian?
Yes, ma'am.
This is what a Hamiltonian function defined. Okay? Now, the important point or important equation we are going to see. Many times the question is asked in the SET exam that related to Hamilton's canonical equation of a motion. Hamilton's canonical equations of motion. Okay. Now let us go for that. The first one that we have to write down is H is equals to summation over J Pj Qj dot minus L, which is equals to some equation 1. Okay, where H is a function of Pj, Qj and P. Right? We have written H is a function of Pj, Qj and P. And L is a function of Qj, Qj dot and T. Okay. Now if I want to show Hamilton's canonical equations of motion, first we'll find out by using this equation and this equation, we'll go for firstly dH. Okay, first we'll find out the value of dH, and dH, after finding the value of a dH from equation, this equation, you can say this, say as equation 2, and then we have to find out the value of a dH from equation 1, and here Hamilton has defined Hamiltonian as summation over J Pj Qj dot n minus L, and here H is defined in terms of Pj Qj and T. Now let me write down the value of a dH. What will be dH from this equation 2 is nothing but summation over J dPj, right? Okay, dPj into, or we can write it as if you want to write down in terms of a derivative. So what will be dH? It is nothing but derivative of H with respect to Pj dPj plus summation over J derivative of H with respect to Qj and dQj plus derivative of H with respect to T and dT. Okay, this is what your equation 3, which is obtained with the help of finding the equation 2. Right? Any doubt up to this? Have you understood this step, equation 3?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, we have simply found the derivative h with respect to pj and derivative pj with respect to d. That means dpj, just like our df. Now, how to write out df? It is nothing but dou f by dou x dx plus dou f by dou y dy plus dou f by dou z dz. Okay, in this way we have to write down. Okay, now let us go for the next one, that is we have to find out dh with equation 1. What is dh? It is nothing but summation over j, we have to keep it as it is. Then it is dpj into qj dot plus summation over j as it is, qj dot will be as it is, we have to find out dpj. Just like a u into v rule for a derivative, minus d l qj qj dot and t. Okay. Now we have to work for this l also, correct?
मॅडम तिथं समेशन जे पी जे डॉट क्यू जे डी क्यू जे डॉट असायला पाहिजे ना.
हियर ना, ओके सॉरी, आय थिंक यू आर सेइंग अबाउट हियर. We have to do this by using our equation number 1. dx is equals to summation over j dpj and qj dot as it is plus. We have to find out dqj dot and pj as it is. Summation over j will be there minus dl. Okay. Now let me find out the value of a dl. Because since L is a function of qj, qj dot and t. So this is what summation over j dpj into qj dot plus summation over j pj into d qj dot minus, you have to find out dl. What is a d value of a dl? It is nothing but summation over j dou l by dou qj into dqj, correct, minus the same term summation over j l with respect to qj dot into dqj dot plus next term is dou l by dou t into dt. Okay, actually this should be with negative sign, since this negative sign we have to keep inside. Now which term are going to get cancelled? If you remember this one, pj is equals to dou l by dou qj dot. This somewhere in the our first chapter we have studied. आठवतंय का कुणाला? pj is nothing but dou l by dou qj dot. This we have studied somewhere in the cyclic coordinate. Value of our momentum, that is pj momentum, is nothing but rate of change of l with respect to qj dot. If l with respect to qj dot is pj, so this value is nothing but pj, right? Pj into dqj dot, here is also pj into dqj dot, so this term will get cancelled with this, correct? So we have the summation over j. dpj into qj dot minus summation over j l with respect to qj dqj minus dou l by dou t into dt. Okay. Now we have to compare those equations. Okay, so let me compare these equations. The equation number 3 we have to compare with equation say 4. This is whatever equation 4 and 3. After comparing these equation, we have to write down the result. dPj. Okay, here is dPj and the coefficient of dPj we have to check. Okay, the coefficient of dPj we will write. Comparing the coefficient of dPj, dQj and dt. The coefficient of dPj from equation 4 is qj dot. Okay, next from equation 3. It is dou h by dou pj, right? So let me write down dou h by dou pj. Okay, next, comparing the coefficient of dqj, it is nothing but minus dou l by dou qj, which is equals to, now the we have to compare it with 3. The coefficient of dqj is h with respect to qj. Okay. Plus, what is the next term? Comparing the coefficient of dt. What is the value of the comparing the coefficient? It is nothing but dou h by dou t. The last one, equation number 3. Dou h by dou t is equals to minus dou l by dou t. Okay. So, as we know, we have to now find out the value of dou l by dou qj. So how to find out this value? We know Lagrange's equation of a motion. What is Lagrange's equation of a motion? Dou L by dou Qj minus T by dt of dou L by dou Qj dot is equal to 0. Now what is the value of dou L by dou Qj dot we have is Pj. Minus this is what d by dt of pj equal to 0. So which means that pj d by dt of a pj, that we can write it as pj dot is equals to dou l by dou qj dot. Pj dot is nothing but dou l by dou qj dot. So here I can write dou l by dou qj dot. Should be dou l by dou qj, no? Here it is dou l by dou qj. So here it should be dou l by dou qj. The value of dou l by dou qj, we got it as pj dot. So these are nothing but your Hamilton's canonical equations of motion. And many times in your exam, the question is asked as that exam is a MCQ type. They ask a question like, you are provided with one options A, B, C, D. They will give some different combinations. Somewhere they, iski jagah pe aap PJ hoga, yahan pe QJ hoga. Some different combinations they are going to give. The question is like this, which of the following is the Hamilton's canonical equations of motion? There may be some another combinations. Here instead of having pj dot, they may give qj dot. Here it is pj. Instead of having h, they may give some another variable. And hence, actually, this is very important according to set exam as well as for theory. So you should by heart these Hamilton's canonical equations of motion. How many equations of motion we have seen is, first one is Lagrange's equation of motion, that is dou l by dou qj minus d by dt of dou l by dou qj dot. Okay, this is the first equation we have seen. Right, the second equation we have seen is d by dt of dou f by dou y dash. Sorry, here d by dx of dou f by dou y dash minus dou f by dou y equal to 0, and the sixth version of Euler-Lagrange's theorem we have seen, and this is what the Hamilton's canonical equations of motion. Any doubt up to this?
No, ma'am.
बाकीचे झोपलेत का आहेत का नाही?
Yes, ma'am.
जागे आहेत?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Let us do one exercise at home. Those who are present, those who are mentally present. What you have to do? You have to. I think everyone know about yoga.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
कुठल्या आसन मध्ये आता सगळे शवासन करतायत का?
नो मॅम.
नो मॅम.
धनुरासन माहिती आहे?
नाही माहित मॅम.
कधीच नाही ट्राय केलं?
माहित नाहीये मॅम ते.
सो दॅट्स वाय व्हॉट आय एम आस्किंग यू नो यू हॅव्हंट ट्राईड योगा. It is a very simple step, but actually I can't do here. It needs a mat for doing that procedure. Why I'm doing this? Because if you are not mentally present, or हम लोग क्या करते हैं, कोई मीटिंग है तो गूगल मीट ओपन करके रखते हैं ना. सो दैट्स आई एम सेइंग इफ यू आर प्रेजेंट यू हैव टू डू सम यू हैव टू परफॉर्म अ धनुरासन. ओके. आई डोंट नो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म. Okay. असे हात वर घेऊ शकता सगळे?
Yes, ma'am.
So at least you will feel relaxed that actually we are going to attend the lectures. जे अटेंड करतायत तेच करणार ना, बाकीचे कोणी कोणी करणार नाही. ओके. लेट अस गो फॉर नेक्स्ट डेरिवेशन. दॅट इज शो दॅट अ कोऑर्डिनेट विच इज सायक्लिक इन लॅग्रेंजियन इज ऑल्सो सायक्लिक इन हॅमिल्टोनियन. ओके. वी हॅव सीन अ सायक्लिक कोऑर्डिनेट इनिशियली इन द फर्स्ट चॅप्टर. वॉट इज अ सायक्लिक कोऑर्डिनेट? द कोऑर्डिनेट विच इज ऑब्सेंट in the Lagrangian L is called a cyclic coordinate. Okay, the coordinate which is absent in the Lagrangian L is called a cyclic coordinate. Okay, now suppose L is a function Lagrangian, here qj, qj dot and p. So if some of the coordinates say q1, if it is absent in L, then it is called a cyclic coordinate. Okay, the coordinate which is absent is called a cyclic coordinate. Now what is the question? Show that the coordinate which is cyclic in Lagrangian, coordinate which is cyclic in Lagrangian is also cyclic in Hamiltonian. Now before going to that, whether you know what is a cyclic coordinate in Lagrangian, what is the effect? Because already I have declared the internal. Even every teacher is going to take the internal from the 10th. 10 तारीख खूप दूर नाही आहे ना, असं विचार करू नका की 10 तारीख खूप लांब आहे, 3 तारीख आहे आज, राईट? सो फ्रॉम 3 to 10 हाऊ मेनी डेज वी हॅव? 7 डेज, राईट? ॲटलीस्ट 1 डे फॉर 1 पेपर. सो हाऊ मेनी डेज वी हॅव? ओनली 5 डेज. अँड इन आफ्टर कम्प्लिशन ऑफ दोज 5 डेज यू हॅव ओनली 2 डेज टू हॅव अ रिव्हिजन. You want to really appear for MCQ examination. Rather, you can cheat also now, because no doubt we are going to have a online examinations, right? So hence, can anyone tell me what is the effect of a cyclic coordinate in Lagrangian as you are going to appear for the internal within few days? आता कोणी जॉईन केला? वाय सो लेट? हॅव यू स्टार्टेड युअर स्टडी? आवाज येतोय का माझा?
यस मॅम.
हा, चालू केलेत का अभ्यास?
यस मॅम.
हो मॅम.
एटलीस्ट फर्स्ट चॅप्टर तर झाला असेल ना? दोन चॅप्टर वर इंटरनल आहे आपली.
मॅम सिलेबस खूप आहे इंटरनलला.
मग आधी काय केलं तुम्ही? दोन महिने असेच घालवलेत का? मी आधीच सांगितलं होतं ना आम्ही इंटरनल घेणार आहेत म्हणून. एव्हरीथिंग वॉज क्लिअर टू यू पीपल? एव्हरी टीचर टोल्ड यू द सिलेबस, द पॅटर्न, द इंटरनल एक्झाम, एक्सटर्नल एक्झाम? Okay, let us now assume that say QJ is a cyclic coordinate in L. Let us assume QJ is a cyclic coordinate in L. Assume that QJ is cyclic coordinate. And what do you mean by cyclic coordinate? Dou L by dou QJ is equal to zero. Okay. The Lagrange's equations of motion are given by, what is the equation of motion? Dou L by dou QJ minus d by dt of dou L by dou QJ dot. I am repeating once again because you haven't answered me. This we have already done in the first chapter. So here, if QJ is absent, dou L by dou QJ is zero. Just like a function f is a function of x, y, z, which means that suppose it is of the form x, y squared. So in this case, z is absent. What is the derivative of a function f with respect to z? It is
zero.
Okay. So in this very similar way, dou L by dou QJ will be zero. So if it is zero, we can write it as minus t by dt of dou L by dou QJ dot is equals to zero. Now what is the value of dou L by dou QJ dot? It is nothing but PJ, which is equal to zero. Now after integrating with respect to t, it will be PJ is equal to some constant. आता तर आठवला का हे QJ सायक्लिक असताना करस्पॉन्डिंग पी जे कॉन्स्टंट असतो असं लिहिलं होतं ना?
यस मॅम. यस मॅम.
QJ इज अ सायक्लिक इन एल, देन करस्पॉन्डिंग जनरलाइज्ड सॉरी करस्पॉन्डिंग मोमेंटम पी जे ऑर रादर वी कॅन से जनरलाइज्ड मोमेंटम इज कॉन्स्टंट. ओके, नाउ लेट अस गो व्हॉट इज द इफेक्ट ऑन एच. नाउ फॉर दॅट वी नो Hamilton's canonical equations of a motion. What are the Hamilton's canonical equations of motion? Pj dot is equals to minus dou h by dou Qj. Okay. And the next equation is Pj dot is nothing but minus dou h by dou Qj. If Pj is a constant term, what will be Pj dot?
Zero.
So if it is zero, we can say minus dou h by dou qj equal to zero, correct? So which means that dou h by dou qj is equals to zero. That means if QJ is a cyclic in L, then corresponding PJ is constant, as well as the derivative of rather Hamiltonian H with respect to QJ is also zero. Okay. If QJ is cyclic, what is the corresponding result? H with respect to QJ is also zero. Okay. As we have started late, that's why we'll continue up to G. Okay. Your real analysis lecture was up to 1:15, na? आधीच सांगितलं तर बरं असेल ना, नाहीतर तुम्हाला पण टेन्शन. मॅडम का जास्त घ्यायले. फिजिकल सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ हॅमिल्टन प्रिन्सिपल. Physical significance of Hamiltonian function. Okay. This was a question asked in the set exam. I don't know exactly the date, but many times this question is asked, just like Hamilton's canonical equations of motion. This question is also asked, physical significance of Hamilton's function. Actually, these are some statement. This statement, they are going to create some confusion. With the help of that, they are going to create an MCQ. Okay. So first I will write down both statement. You have to read and you have to understand this, and then afterwards we'll going to prove it. Show that for conservative system. Can anyone tell me what is a conservative system? No one knows what is a conservative system.
When the forces acting on the system is conservative.
Forces are constant or conservative. That means force acting on the any system is constant, and it's called a conservative system. Force is constant, it is called a conservative system. Constant of motion and total energy. When the constraints are economic, H may be a constant of motion. Then constraints are rheonomic. Then Hamiltonian H may represent may be a constant of motion. But does not represent the total energy. Some twists are created by set exam. क्वेश्चन सेट एग्जाम क्वेश्चन में डायरेक्टली नहीं पूछा जाएगा ना. दे विल क्रिएट सम ट्विस्ट एंड यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर दिस स्टेटमेंट आफ्टर क्रिएटिंग द कंफ्यूजन एंड ऑल यू शुड आंसर इट वेरी शार्पली. ओके दे इंस्टेड ऑफ सेइंग स्क्लेरोनॉमिक और रियोनॉमिक दे मे से दैट इट इन्वॉल्व्स टाइम टी इट डज नॉट इन्वॉल्व टाइम टी. स्क्लेरोनॉमिक मीन्स इट डज नॉट इन्वॉल्व अ टाइम टी एंड रियोनॉमिक मीन्स इट इन्वॉल्व्स अ टाइम टी. Okay, or instead of saying conservative system, they can say that the force is constant. And then the MCQ may be of the type A. In the conservative system, constraints are not involving a time T, then Hamiltonian H represent dot dot dot. Okay, or they may have both the statement and the options may be both are true, only one is true, only two is true. Both are false. This type of a statement will be there. Any doubt with this? How the MCQs are asked? If not, let us go for proving the result. Before that, I want to ask you: is there any problem with my teaching? खूब दिवस झाले मी काही विचारलेच नाही. ते सिलेबस जास्त आहे ना तुमचा. अजून एप्रिल मध्ये एग्जाम पण आहे. Right? So that's why I want to ask you. I think initially in some 2 to 3 lecture I have asked you. Is there any problem with my teaching? Explain karat nahi kiwa kay pan. Any type of a problem? Shant ahet manje khup problem hai.
No one.
No problem. Definition explain करत नाही किंवा example जास्त घेत नाही किंवा fast आहे का slow आहे. Any type of problem you can say. Because in today's lecture I have asked many type of a question from the first chapter. And if first chapter we have already learned, we should answer these questions, na? No doubt there must be a problem of my writing. Not still capable to use a pen tablet. It is somewhat difficult to use. Even agar aap mere physical lecture bhi karte to thoda sa writing ka problem hai. Agar mera bahut zyada mood acha raha to hi writing bahut achhi aati hai. Otherwise it is somewhat difficult. It doesn't mean that my mood is bad in the lectures. It means that agar main dil se kuch likh rahi hu to bahut acha aata hai writing. Otherwise actually pen tablet pe utna aadat nahi hai likhne ka. No problem with my teaching. What we are going to see, the first one is when the constraints are scleronomic, we have to prove that the H is a cost of motion as well as a total energy. Okay, let us go one by one. What is H? H is nothing but a function of Pj, Qj and T. Okay, what will be dH by dt? Because if I want to prove H to be a constant of motion, I have to prove that the derivative of H with respect to any variable, if it is equal to zero, then which means that your H is a constant. Okay?
No, ma'am.
Summation over J, dou H by dou PJ. Into pj dot. If you are going to differentiate with respect to t, it is pj dot plus summation over j dou h by dou qj into derivative of a qj with respect to t plus h with respect to t and derivative of t with respect to t, it will be 1. Okay. Now, when constants are scleronomic, what is the value of L with respect to T? Scleronomic means what? L does not involve a time T. So what will be dou L by dou T? That means in case of a scleronomic constraint, when the Lagrangian L does not involve a time T, dou L by dou T equal to 0. Many examples we have solved about the Lagrange's equation of a motion. At that time, we first find the value of a t, then we find the value of v, then we find L is equals to t minus v. At that time, it may present x or it may present x dot and like this. Ata deka hai?
Yes, ma'am.
So dou L by dou t equals to 0 means what? We are in the case of a scleronomic constraint. Okay, now let us now go for the Hamilton's canonical equations of motion. What are Hamilton's canonical equation of motion? Pj dot is equals to minus dou h by dou qj. Qj dot is equals to dou h by dou pj. Dou h by dou t is equals to minus dou l by dou t. Then equation 1, that is our equation dh by dt. What is our dh by dt? It is nothing but summation over j. Now let us put up the values. Dou h by dou pj means what? The value of dou h by dou pj is qj dot into, it is pj dot minus. Why minus? Because we have to now substitute the value of dou h by dou qj. What is the value of a dou h by dou qj? It is nothing but minus pj dot. Okay, minus pj dot. Next term. What is the next term here is qj dot. And this summation as it is. Plus what is the next term? Dou h by dou t is equals to minus dou l by dou t. But just now we have written if we are in the case of scleronomic constraint, it means that it does not involve a time t. Then dou l by dou t equal to 0. Okay. So which means that dou L by dou T equal to 0 means dou H by dou T is also equal to 0. Okay, here also you can see PJ dot QJ dot, PJ dot QJ dot with negative sign, with positive sign. Both get cancelled and hence we get it equal to 0. Hence DH by DT equal to 0, which means that value of H is a constant. Okay. So in this way, in the first part, we have proved that H is a constant of motion. And the next one, we have to prove that H is a total energy, that is T plus V. Okay, H represents the total energy. Now what is given to us? L does not contain the time T. Why it does not contain the time T? Because we are in the case of a scleronomic constraint. If scleronomic constraints are there, then we know that V is not a function of QJ dot. Potential energy is not a function of a QJ dot. If potential energy is not a function of a what is the value of potential energy that is derivative of potential energy with respect to QJ dot? It will be 0. And hence, what is the value of L? L is nothing but T minus V. And if you remember one formula that we have studied in the first chapter, last derivation, QJ dot into dou T by dou QJ dot is equals to 2T. This we have already studied in the first chapter, last theorems. Last 2 to 3 theorems we have studied. In that, what is the value of PJ is? Dou L by dou QJ dot is nothing but PJ, which is nothing but dou L by L is nothing but your T minus V with respect to QJ dot. Okay, so which is dou T by dou QJ dot minus dou V by dou QJ dot. But here dou V by dou QJ dot will be 0. So in this way, we get the value of PJ is equals to dou T by dou QJ dot. Okay, So now we have to just substitute the value here. Dou t by dou qj dot is nothing but pj. So 2t is equals to summation over j pj into qj dot. T is equals to summation over j pj into qj dot. Okay, now what is the value of h? We have obtained h is nothing but summation over j pj into qj dot minus l. What is the value of summation over j pj qj dot, which we have obtained is 2 into t, which is equals to 2t minus l is nothing but t minus v. We have written many times 2t minus t will be t minus minus become plus, and hence we represent h is equals to t plus v, and h is a constant of motion. This we have already proved. Okay. Any doubt in today's lecture? In any theorem? करत शांत आहेत सगळे. करा एक्सरसाइज, करत जा सकाळी सकाळी.
मॅम, ते डो पोटेन्शियल एनर्जी विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू क्यू जे डॉट इक्वल टू झिरो कसं आले?
फर्स्ट लेक्चर मध्ये आपण सांगितलं, फर्स्ट युनिट मध्ये, पोटेन्शियल एनर्जी इफ इट इज नॉट अ फंक्शन ऑफ क्यू जे डॉट, देन वी हॅव derivative of potential energy with respect to qj dot is zero. Have you attended that lecture in the first chapter? First chapter madhe he zalela ahe. Rather not first time, many times we have done it. Yes, can you say me, have you attended that lectures?
Yes ma'am.
Then you have to go back and you have to study first chapter, because still you have to appear for internal.
Okay,
else